Now you've already heard me referring to using an open-circuited transmission line in much the same way that we use a short-circuited transmission line. So consider a transmission line of length L and characteristic impedance Z0 that is terminated with an open circuit, which has an impedance of infinity. The reflection coefficient of the load is ZL minus Z0 over ZL plus Z0. Since this is infinity over infinity, the Z0s are very small compared to infinity. Our reflection coefficient is 1. The voltage any place on this line, remember Z equals 0 here, and Z equals minus L at the input, is always equal to V0 plus times e to the j beta z plus the reflection coefficient e to the minus j beta z. Since the reflection coefficient is 1, we can find the voltage from an open circuit. The current, as a function of z, is V0 plus divided by Z0 times e to the j beta z minus the reflection coefficient times e to the minus j beta z. Again, the reflection coefficient is 1 for an open circuit. Now let's go back and consider the sine and the cosine terms for this case just the same way we did for the short circuit. In this case, this is going to give us 2 V0 plus times the cosine of beta z. This term is going to be minus 2j V0 plus divided by Z0 times the sine of beta z. Now let's consider the impedance. If we're interested in the impedance of an open circuit, we simply need to take the ratio of the open-circuited voltage to the open-circuited current. And that's going to give us 2 V0 plus times the cosine of beta z divided by minus 2j V0 plus divided by Z0 times the sine of beta z. Our V0 pluses cancel out, our 2s cancel out, and our minus j is going to come up to the top as a positive j. That's going to give us j, and here we have cosine over sine, that's cotangent of beta z. If we're interested in the input impedance for this open circuit, that is the same as ZOC at minus L. We just plug minus L right in here for z. That's going to give us minus j cotangent of beta z. I can see I left out my Z0 in both of these cases, so let's go tuck it back in there. Now this again is a line that is strictly reactive. It's strictly got a negative j. There's no real part. So this can represent either j omega L for inductance, or 1 over j omega c, same as minus j over omega c. So again, we expect this line is going to be able to be either inductive or capacitive. Let's see how that works.